Hey guys, welcome to Flipped Video number 5. Today we're going to be discussing a few topics like John Lewis, Jimmy Carter, the 1996 Atlanta Olympics, and Georgia's role in the national and global economy of the 21st century. John Lewis may not feel like he fits into those topics. He is new to our standards this year, and so added him here instead of going back and redoing another video. John Lewis is known as a civil rights activist. He later served as a city councilman and then a U.S. representative, and he is currently still a U.S. representative. John Lewis is often called one of the bravest or courageous people that the civil rights movement produced. As a civil rights activist, he participated in many sit-ins of freedom rides to protest Jim Crow laws. He did this while in college, and also while in college and moving forward, he became the chair of a new organization called the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee, or the SNCC, or more commonly known as SNCC. The SNCC, or SNCC, participated in sit-ins and freedom rides across the South. This organization was also very committed to voter registration, as was John Lewis. Voter registration is usually a drive set up around town or on college campuses to encourage students to get registered to vote in elections. In 1965, John Lewis led 600 marchers across the Edmund Pettus Bridge in Selma, Alabama. This event was televised and ultimately brought much needed attention to the civil rights movement. It became known as Bloody Sunday because so many people saw it on TV, and it was very gruesome. People were beaten by state troopers, among other things that happened. One interesting fact about John Lewis, in addition to Martin Luther King, he was arrested more than 40 times during the civil rights movement as an activist. Later on, he continues to write for human rights, which I'll get to in a minute, but he co-authored a trilogy of graphic novels for young people like you. They are titled March in all caps if you're interested in looking into that. John Lewis also served as a city councilman. In 1982, he was elected to Atlanta City Council. There, he fought to end corruption in the government and also to preserve the community. When we talk about community preservation, we're talking about he's trying to preserve or save historic sites and open space like parks, but also to create affordable housing for those who need a little bit of help. As a United States representative, John Lewis represents the 5th Congressional District in Georgia. He was elected in 1986, and he currently still serves. As a senior member of the United States House of Representatives, he serves as leadership for the Democratic Party. He also serves on some of the most prestigious and important congressional committees. A lot of people really seek to serve on those committees, and he's been around and fighting for so long that he has earned his place there. He does continue to remain focused on human rights, neighborhood preservation, and eliminating government corruption. In addition, he has won numerous prestigious awards. Next up is Jimmy Carter. Jimmy Carter is from Georgia. He's originally from Plains, Georgia, and here you see him photographed with his wife. He currently resides in Georgia. He is older, but if you're looking for a place to meet him, he still teaches a Sunday school class at a church in South Georgia. In his early life, he was born and raised in Plains, Georgia, and he grew up on a farm and he attended public schools. He attended Georgia Tech, but he won a scholarship or appointment to the Naval Academy, and he was very successful there. He had a career going for him, but his father passed away early, and he returned home to run the family farm and business. And he was actually a peanut farmer. That was his family business. He's very involved in the community in Plains, and he moves forward in working with the education system and public schools in the county. He is then elected to be a state senator in 1962. He continues to advocate for education, and he serves on the Senate Education Committee. So he serves on like the committee that makes decisions about education in the state. He is pro-integration and he is pro-environment. And as president, you will see how he implements those things further. Before we get there, though, he does serve as Georgia's governor. He is elected. People love Jimmy Carter because he is known as the average person. He is a simple farmer. He is very relatable to the people because of that. To give you a little taste of what Jimmy Carter was known for, being the average man, I'm going to go ahead and fast forward to his presidency really quickly and show you one of the political ads that was shown on TV to represent Jimmy Carter.
I'm a Southerner, and I'm proud of a heritage that shows concern for the working men and women who are the backbone of our great nation. These are the people who are often cheated by an unfair system of government. These are the people forgotten by the present administration, while the influential and powerful get special favors. When I'm elected president, that will change.
We in the South can help by voting for Jimmy Carter, a leader for a change.
So that was just a little taste of Jimmy Carter as the average guy, and you saw him on his peanut farm talking about what real people are going through. Some of the things that he focused on as governor is he made the state operate more efficiently. He condensed state services so that things weren't being done twice by different agencies. He also made every government agency justify every dollar they spent. He was a little bit tight on spending. He launched a campaign that led to the creation of a statewide kindergarten program. So you actually went to kindergarten because of this. He started mental health programs in the state, and he promoted equality opportunities for both women and minorities. He is elected to be the president of the United States. He has many achievements while he is president. However, they are a little overshadowed by the disappointments that happened. Let's start with his achievements. First of all, he got Egypt and Israel together at Camp David to sign a peace treaty. This is huge for the Middle East. Camp David is known as the retreat that many presidents go to while they are in office. And there is where they met together. There is a very famous picture of Jimmy Carter standing with the two as they shake hands. And now you can say you've seen it too. President Carter also worked on the SALT Treaty with the Soviet Union, which was a treaty that reduced the number of nuclear weapons that each of our countries would produce and have on hand. He created two new cabinet departments, the Department of Energy and the Department of Education, which should come as no surprise to you considering those are things that he focused on in his earlier career. Unfortunately, while he was in office, America went through a period of time where inflation occurred. They called it stagflation. Stagflation was when prices are going up, but the economy is not changing. And so it increases unemployment and things begin to just cost more in general. The price of oil increases in America and the Iran hostage crisis occurred. This is when 52 American hostages were seized by Iranian students and they were held for 444 days. While they were not injured during this time, they were not released until the minute that Ronald Reagan was sworn into office. After his presidency, Carter was much more successful. He lost his re-election campaign in 1980 to Ronald Reagan, and he returned to Georgia to found the Carter Center. The Carter Center has been very influential in national and international policy issues. He has been involved in many international brokerships, and he has been the professor at Emory University, written numerous books, helped treat diseases worldwide, and supported Habitat for Humanity domestically. Jimmy Carter won the Nobel Peace Prize for his effort in finding peaceful solutions to international conflicts post-presidency. He is always looking to help advance human rights in the United States. The 1996 Olympics were held in Atlanta, Georgia. Georgia was very excited to bring the Olympics to the city because that would result in a lot of new venues to be built and a lot of existing sports venues and sidewalks and other public areas to be repaired. It was huge for the revitalization of the downtown area. It brought in new hotels, homes, and apartments. There was a short-term impact of the Olympics. The creation of Centennial Olympic Park was awesome because it led to a lot of new things coming to the area, restaurants, businesses, hotels, things like that, and other things to be improved, such as the roadways around Atlanta, streetlights to be added. Atlanta was very excited to bring all these things, and Centennial Olympic Park was the home of many things during the Olympics, such as concerts, other activities, and they even built in these Olympic rings that you see over here on the left with the water. You can still go play in those on a hot day. There was a long-term impact of the Olympics on Atlanta. The long-term impact of the Olympics on Atlanta is going to be the continued economic growth of the city. People have to move to cities when the Olympics occur in them because they have to help build the different things that are needed for the events to occur. And also, when you build a hotel, people move to help with the building of those things. We have a lot of years where professionals and businesses move to Atlanta just to be near this and know that the city was about to thrive because of the hosting of the Olympics. The population of the city increases dramatically from 3.5 million people to 5.5 million after the Olympics. According to New Georgia Encyclopedia, at least $5.1 billion came in from having the games in Atlanta. During the games at Centennial Olympic Park, a bomb went off. A man named Eric Rudolph was the person who was accused of the crime. He was on the run for a long time afterwards. There was a hunt for him, as you see on the newspaper to the right there. It was a big deal. This is a terroristic attack on Americans at the Olympics, but not just Americans. It happened in Atlanta, but people from all over the world had come to the Olympics. So this was a big deal.
1:25 this morning, thousands of revelers at an open-air rock concert in Centennial Park.
All of a sudden, I felt a big boom, a blast. Heat came, and then it knocked me off the wall, blew my pants off.
Move up the speed! Everybody needs to move up the speed!
Authorities said the device appeared to be a pipe bomb loaded with nails and screws designed to penetrate human flesh.
More than 100 people have been injured. Two are dead.
So those were some news clips to give you an idea of what it was like. Ultimately, the Atlanta Olympics brought a lot of economic growth to the city, and so they were a good thing. This bombing was a dark spot in a bright place. Next up, we're going to talk about the three areas that Georgia is experiencing growth and its role in the national and global economy of the 21st century.
Oh, I've been walking, eyes open wide, and I've been looking at the brighter side. Travel through the mountains, been to the sea. I've seen the city lights, and I believe life's pretty sweet, pretty sweet, pretty sweet. Like a Georgia peach, my Georgia peach, life's pretty sweet.
So you just got taken on a tour around Georgia through that little video. Tourism has become one of the state's largest industries, bringing in lots of tax money, about $3 billion. State revenue is the fifth largest employer of state revenue. It provides over 439,000 jobs. One third of the tourists from Georgia are actually Georgians who are visiting other areas of the state. For example, we went to Savannah to tour and visit and see what the town was all about earlier this year, and we would be contributing to that one third of the tourists who are touring their own state. We have over 100 million visitors who visit Georgia's mountains and beaches and our major cities throughout the year. Next up is going to be Savannah's harbor expansion. Savannah's port is the fourth busiest container port in the whole United States. You often see containers on semis coming back into Atlanta if you're driving to Savannah on I-16. The outer harbor will reach to 49 feet with water when it is at its lowest point. It is going to be critical for supply chains and expansion of American business ships coming in through Savannah for American imports. Next up is film, and probably one of the more fascinating ones to you. Film growth has expanded exponentially in Georgia over the last few years, but in 1973, Jimmy Carter, who we just discussed, started the Georgia Film Commission. It has grown to be the third, in 2016 was the last time that this was put out, it has been the third place that people film movies or TV shows behind California and New York. It is bringing in tons of money and creating tons of jobs in the state. You may know Tyler Perry. He's a producer and actor, and he is currently converting the former Fort McPherson location into one of the largest film studios in the United States. And wraps up all of the notes for this unit.